Now we are going to see what are the significance of these serology. So one side I will be writing about the antigen, another side I will be writing about the antibodies and their significance. So antigen and antibody significance, right? So whenever we see HB, hepatitis B virus, HBs antigen will be first antigen which will appear in inflammation. So earliest marker of hepatitis B infection. If examiner is using word, earliest marker of hepatitis B infection. So remember, this is the earliest marker of hepatitis B infection. So earliest marker of hepatitis B infection. And here we must remember that it is also epidemiological marker of the hepatitis B infection. So earliest and epidemiological marker of the hepatitis. So epidemiological marker of the hepatitis and earliest marker of hepatitis, both thing will be HBs antigen, right? HBs antigen is never considered as a marker of acute infection because it will be present in both acute and chronic. So it will be present in both acute and chronic. So what is the chronicity definition? When HBs antigen is existing for more than 6 months of the duration, that will be considered as chronic hepatitis B infection, right? So chronicity is defined when HBs antigen is persisting for more than 6 months. So that is important point for HBs antigen. HBs antigen is the earliest marker, epidemiological marker. It will be present in both acute and chronic inflammation. So that is why it cannot discriminate acute. When they are present more than 6 months of duration, it will be considered as chronic hepatitis B infection, right? So that is the interpretation of the presence of HBs antigen. So whenever you find HBs antigen, this will be the interpretation. When we are seeing antibodies, so antibody against HBs antigen. So antibody against HBs antigen will be suggestive of active or passive immunization. So this will be suggestive of active or passive immunization. So active or passive immunization, you will be seeing anti-HBs will be present. And what is the significance? Anti-HBs present means it is protected. So it means that individual is protected. So protected individual, anti-HBs is present, protected individual, or active and passive immunization has been given to that person. Right, HBs antigen, earliest marker, epidemiological marker, and if it is more than 6 months, it will be considered as chronic. Right, so after that, HBc antigen. Second, this antigen is HBc antigen. Right, HBc antigen, what is characteristic? It is not detectable in serum. So it's very simple, not detectable in serum, right? So HBc core antigen is not detectable in serum. So what we are going to detect in serum? In serum we can identify antibody against them, right? So antibody against HBc antigen is detectable in serum, right? So IgM antibodies, so there are two types of antibodies we'll be seeing, IgM and IgG. So IgM type of HBc antibody and IgG type of HBc antibody. So these are two types of antibodies, right? IgM is the earliest marker of acute infection. Earliest marker for acute infection. So this is very important and very frequently asked question. Earliest marker for the hepatitis B infection. So when examiner says earliest marker of hepatitis B infection, it will be IgM HBc, right? Earliest marker of acute hepatitis infection.
Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.